Things is so much fun. Here comes Andy Pandy in Andy Pandy Land.
It was a hot, sunny afternoon. It was so hot and sunny that Andy Pandy and his friends had all been having an afternoon nap. After their rest, Andy and Looby Lou were planning to have a picnic with Teddy in the shade of the old tree. Andy was going to take a jug of cool lemonade to the picnic. Now he needed some straws from his special cupboard. A pair of dark sunglasses. Just the thing for such a sunny day. Looby Lou had remembered her special fan. It would keep her cool while she made sandwiches. Teddy was already on his way to the picnic, but he found the sun too bright. Then he felt too hot. Teddy wanted a pair of sunglasses just like Andy's. But Andy had found only one pair, so Teddy would have to make his own. Looby Lou and Andy were both ready for the picnic. But what was Bilbo the sailor doing? He was trying to keep everyone else cool by fanning them with his sail. Andy asked everyone if they'd like to join the picnic in the shade of the old tree. Teddy had almost finished making a pair of dark sunglasses from black cardboard. Now he had to bend the sides so that they'd fit onto his head. Under the old tree, everyone felt a bit too hot to eat Looby Lou's sandwiches. But they all wanted Andy's cool lemonade. There was only one thing wrong with Teddy's black cardboard sunglasses. He couldn't see through them. Teddy had walked straight into the side of Bilbo the sailor's house. No one knew Teddy couldn't see where he was going and called him over to the picnic. Andy Pandy still didn't know that Teddy couldn't see through his new sunglasses and asked if they could swap. As soon as Andy tried on Teddy's sunglasses, everything went as dark as night. He thought it was time for bed. Just as Looby Lou caught up with Andy, the sun went in. Nobody needed to wear sunglasses anymore. It was much cooler now, so everyone was ready to enjoy Looby Lou's sandwiches. Looby let Andy and Teddy have the first sandwich. Wearing sunglasses had made them both very hungry indeed.